Blessed love, sacred women, and welcome to Sacred Woman, Wise Woman Chats, Birthing Beautiful. Today I wanted to talk about birth as the ancestral legacy. And I think a lot of times when women are trying to conceive or in the space of creating a family and wanting that, they get so excited or inundated with the everyday, the getting pregnant, the becoming fertile, the or maybe not just getting pregnant, and then the changes that happen physically in the body and the changes that happen physically in the family space, what's the finances, the shifts that come. However, there's a part of birth and there's a part of creating a family that's not widely discussed, and that is the effect of birth on your ancestral path or your ancestral lineage, the opportunity for pregnancy and birthing to be opportunity to revisit your own childhood experiences, thoughts and beliefs about how you were raised, and that's as simple as how you were fed. Some households, for me for instance, I was born into a meat-eating family, except for my father. My father was a vegetarian. And then when I created my own family, based on the information that was afforded to me about a plant-based diet, that is what I decided was going to be best for my family. So I changed that cycle and that inheritance, you know, for lack of a better word. However, there are other things that are more deep in terms of what we inherit from those who have gone before us, including temperance. Temperance is actually an inheritance. We inherit personality in a sense, and sometimes even that can be something that's beneficial or not beneficial. So birthing from an ancestral perspective, in the Ifa tradition, we believe that a child is a returning ancestor. A child is a one of your predecessors, could be as close as your grandmother or your grandfather, which is called Babatunde if they're returning, or Iyatunde if it's a female, if she's returning. But there's a belief that this child is coming back through the lineage to progress it. This child has a destiny, and this child has a purpose within the family scope first, and then has a purpose within the community that they're born in to fulfill in some way. Also in the Ifa tradition, when a child is born, there's a ritual that is performed called an esentaye. And an esentaye is done to communicate with Orun, which is what we call heaven, where the contract to come to the earth, Aye, was signed. And what is that contract? We forget as we go through the birth canal. The birth canal erases our memory. And so we have this ritual that's done that lays out not only the lifespan, the destiny of the child, but also lays out things that can be a hindrance to that child achieving their destiny, or a plus. So they're called taboos, or they're called good fortune. And you learn early as parents, what are the taboos for your children? What are not good practices for them? And then you also learn what are good practices, what are good fortune practices for your children to help them to fulfill their destiny on the earth, which in our tradition is what we believe the purpose of all births for. The purposing of birthing children is for them to fulfill their destiny on the earth, whatever it is that they chose or was chosen for them, and also to progress the lineage and to undo things that may have not been beneficial to the lineage span. So with that said, birth has a whole other perspective from a West African Ifa Orisha perspective. Birth has a responsibility to not just expand the immediate family in which is receiving the blessing, but birth also has the responsibility of balancing the lineage generations before and generations forward.